Hey, welcome back into today's video. We're going to be talking about Taylor Nicole Dean. She's most known for being what's called a pet tuber, and that means that she has a lot of animals. And there's this alleged controversy going around on the internet, has been going around on the internet for a good bit, where she's known to be, notoriously known to be an animal hoarder. Now, there was some recent news that broke, and we're going to be covering that today, but we're going to catch you up on what's been going on. So bring out the rep monks as we explore YouTubers. Taylor Nicole Dean has 1,611,561 subscribers, so she's got a little bit of a following. She's been pretty absent more recently after a smaller YouTuber had exposed her in a video. This video was released on November 10th of 2018. It's titled, Taylor Nicole Dean is an Animal Hoarder and Her Relationship with Jonny Craig is Not Goals. Now, if you're unfamiliar with who Jonny Craig is, Jonny Craig, Jonathan Monroe Craig, is a Canadian-American singer and songwriter. Jonny previously contributed as lead vocalist with acts Dance Gavin Dance, Emma Rosa, Ghost Runner on Third, Western Halts, and Slaves as a solo artist. He has released 2 studio albums, 2 EPs, a live album to date. He's born March 26th, 1986, at the age of 32 years old. More recently, she has went silent and deleted her Twitter account and went dark on her social media. So this story that broke just the other day is probably more than likely the most damaging thing that's ever happened to her career, and it's very hard to come back from things like this. I know that you're like, oh man, what is it? Well, you better get your tea mugs ready.
For those who don't know, there have been accusations floating around that I neglect, abuse, and just let my animals die off and replace them. And I'm hoping I can clear up some of the confusion and just talk about mistakes I've made in the past.
Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through this video. We're going to listen to her response to this expose video that was out on her in November, and we're going to back it up with evidence and fact check her to make sure that she is telling the truth, because it's important that we put everything out there. And I am going to be putting this out here in a neutral, unbiased fashion. That way you can better judge the whole situation.
Start with the accusations that I kill and replace my animals. That accusation is completely baseless. No one has any proof whatsoever that that's true.
Not one single person has proof. They're baseless accusations. That's weird, because I guess I'm that person. On October 17th, 2018, she released a statement after a tragic accident. This month, something absolutely heartbreaking happened. My electricity in my animal room malfunctioned while I was asleep. Basically, the breaker box shut off all electricity in there for around 12 hours. That alone, thankfully, caused no problems. But when I went to turn it back on, there was clearly an issue with one of the power strips. I didn't notice this, and that is clearly my fault. But basically, the temperature regulators that I had for an entire row of my cages never turned back on after this. This happened the morning time, and by nighttime, I realized something was very wrong. She returned 9 to 10-ish hours later to the room to turn everyone's lights off and feed and water. And that's when she realized that, and this is gonna sound graphic, but her Pac-Man frog and her 2 crocodile, I think they're called crocodile skinks, correct me if I'm wrong, they had been baked alive. She goes on to say, I want you all to know you can trust me and that I'll never cover up any mistake I make to try to make myself look better at the expense of all of your trust. But there was a tweet that was released, and it's very condemning. It says, my tweets from last night are about Taylor Nicole Dean. It was a reaction to being told her skinks and frog died from improper care and that she replaced them. Imagine my surprise to wake up this morning and see she claims they died from an accident, believe me or not. That's what I was told. Now, this person is a part of a group that Taylor Nicole Dean was a part of, and Nicole did respond with this. How'd she make up a rumor 10 hours before Taylor said anything about it, lol? Taylor says, I told all my friends the animals had died before I posted it online. We already know who made this up because she's no longer in our group. Now, I gotta ask yourself, who would make this up? Really, who would do that? And I know there's some messed up people in the world, but I want to say that there is no proof that this is what happened. We have to take Taylor's word for it. But given the past of things that have happened, it's very difficult to do this because somebody out there is keeping a whole track record of her animals, and it gives you a pretty good oversight of everything that's going on. Last updated today at 4:21. And it's a list of all the animals that she's had since she's been on YouTube. And it's not looking good. From my calculations, currently there are 28 confirmed dead, 10 that are missing in action, and 24 that are claimed to be rehomed, but there's not much evidence on a bunch of those. I'm going to put this link in the description so you guys can check it out. So that adds up to potentially 52 to 62 deaths. That's a lot of lives lost. That rivals, if not more, I'm pretty sure that's more lives lost to a human being than Ted Bundy.
Anyway, to sum it up, I have heat regulators because I have a lot of heat lamps and a lot of heating pads and just a lot of heat in my animal room. And so if I didn't have something to regulate the heat, it would get extremely, extremely hot in there, and there'd be no way that each animal got the exact temperature they needed. So I have heating regulators hooked up to my animals' cages that have the temperature, the max temperature that the cage can get to before the heating thing shuts off.
So her Pac-Man frog and her skinks were both in the same cages. And I actually, my degree from college is in electrical and electrical industrial. I have a dual in it. And I know a lot about electricity. And I can say that for the breaker to blow like she says it did, there had to been a lot of things hooked up to it. And that just goes back to this. Yeah, she might have not been at complete fault for what happened to the electrical outlets, but if she overloaded the circuit breaker, that goes to irresponsibility. And also, it's a two-bedroom apartment. You can't put that heavy of a load of all these things. So, barring the fact that she has too many animals for a two-bedroom apartment, she's got too much power going into their outlets, which could be a big fire hazard. My main concern is that the animals are living in an environment that is unsafe. And the next thing she's going to bring up is everybody talking about the death toll, which she gets completely wrong. But the way she just talks about it, just looking at her facial expressions, my mirror neurons are not lining up with how she's portraying this.
And then, yeah, here and there, I mean, my hedgehogs have died. I've had other animals die, but the way they're making it sound is like, I'm just like, they're just dropping like flies, like snake after snake after snake, and then Bindi, and then Twisty, and then all this, but they're all doing great. So yes, I have had deaths, but it's nowhere near the extreme that people are making it sound. I'm not saying that that number isn't real. I'm sure that there have been 20 living beings that I've brought into my home that have passed away.
Actually, let's count them right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. That's 28 confirmed dead. 28 confirmed dead, 10 unknown, and 24 rehomed. That's 52 deaths, potentially. So her 20 was a little bit low on that. And I'm pretty sure if we're counting these as lives, which we definitely should, Ted Bundy, he killed 30 people. And honestly, the only reason I'm bringing this up is because there's a documentary on Netflix. Have you seen it? Let me know. I like to believe that people don't set out to just do these horrible things, and that there's probably some mental issues that's barring deep down inside them. But the way she's going about and the way she talks about her animals doesn't seem like me. I love my cat, Greg. You know, I don't even look at him as a cat. To me, he's like a human being. And I don't even like calling him a pet. I don't think I would, you know. And just the way she's coming off just doesn't feel right. And I think that she needs to understand that's why people are concerned. The next thing we're going to talk about is her cats and what actually happened. There was a lot of controversy surrounding it last year. The one that did survive, his name's Nemo. Let's hear it from her perspective.
It was very, very bonded with them immediately. And I wanted to take care of these guys. And maybe that's not, maybe that was wrong. Maybe. And sadly, at one point, the female kitten did stop responding well. She wasn't eating. After an hour and a half of her refusing food, I rushed her over to the vet. They did a full workup of her. They said that she honestly looked fine. Maybe she just was.
Now, this is where I'm confused, and it's where I feel like she's losing me in this. And you guys are going to have to correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that she said she took him to the vet before she brought him home. But she's saying here that she took the cat to the vet when she figured out it was sick. Here's a tweet posted on lolcow. I'll put it in the description below. Proof the kittens were healthy when she found them and that the female wasn't unknowingly sick. She didn't die from neglect. She posts the male's full workup, but doesn't post the female's full workup, which is weird. And I'm seeing a trend of her doing things like this, but you can see that even in the male, it says 96.3, and kittens are supposed to be more around 100, I believe. I think, quote, don't quote me on that. And they need, the temperatures are very important about them eating, and you have to keep them on heating pads and warm, or they can get gravely ill. One user says, am I reading this wrong? Why does the first page say female and the second say male? Aren't you proving the female's health or the male's? She says, I was trying to show I brought them both to the vet before the girl got sick. It's very contradicting. One user says, I'm confused. If they were healthy when she got them, that wouldn't rule out neglect. That would mean you did something wrong. So that right there seems like she was caught in a little bit of a fib.
My other thing to respond to about the cats is the one that I brought in as a companion for Nemo after his sister passed away. I brought in Ghost. I got him at an adoption event, but people insist that he's this cat from Craigslist. I don't even know what I could say about that anymore.
So she acts very surprised as to why people think that this is a lie and the cat's actually from Craigslist. But here's proof why people are concerned and thinking this. As you can see, she tweeted once that these kittens here needed a home, that they were rescues, and she wanted to bring them home. But the issue with it was, is somebody found a Craigslist post of the same kittens, Persian kittens that were $600 a piece. She was exposed upon this and then deleted her original tweet. So when she started saying that she was getting another rescue cat, people were, you know, heightened senses and going to look into it, of course, and found out that the cat was actually a high grade rag. What is it called? Rag. In this tweet, she says, was looking for a friend for Nemo and saw this guy and had to take him. Looks like a rad dog mix of some sort. And those are very expensive kittens. Here's the Craigslist post that people think that she got it from. They're about $650 a piece. And then somebody even puts a whole timeline together that adds up that with maps, Google Maps and everything, like this is the same cat in the Craigslist post, like it gets real. So to be completely honest with you, we know the first one was a cat from Craigslist, and having that behavior in the past, probably, well, who's to say that this is not what she did the second time? And that's just being very disingenuous and lying to your audience. Why don't you just tell them the truth? There's nothing wrong with Craigslist unless you're trying to pick up a date. Don't do that.
This one is the bearded dragon situation. My bearded dragon was sold to me with a damaged tail. I talked about it after I got the amputation, and I talked about my story of trying all different things before amputating.
Now, if you're unfamiliar, she had a bearded dragon that she got from a pet store, and it was hurt already. And she was saying that, pretty much slandering this company, saying that they didn't take care of it, it's their fault that the tail fell off, and then goes on to say the name of the company. But then the company responded back saying, we don't know you, this, you didn't get that from us, like, you're clearly lying.
They kept saying, oh, that's the booth, oh, you know, that flyer in the background literally has their logo, oh, this, oh, that. And so I finally said, you know, that does sound right. I do remember seeing South Texas dragons. Yeah, I think I got it from them, but their bearded dragons look great, other than Twisty. And I literally said that in the video. I literally said in my video, nothing bad about the company. I didn't drop their name. I blurred out their logo. But in a post I did on Instagram, I did drop their name and on Insta.
Wait. Did she just say that she didn't drop their name and then say that she did right after that?
I didn't drop their name. I blurred out their logo. But in a post I did on Instagram, I did drop their name and on Twitter. I said...
Wow. She did. She said, I didn't drop their name. And then right after that says, oh, wait, yeah, I did. Well, anyway, this was really bad because, number one, it wasn't the same company. And she didn't know what she was talking about. But she tweeted out to millions of people that these people were neglectful. It's very slanderous, very hurtful for the business.
I shouldn't have done that. I did not realize the magnitude of my voice on the internet. I never do. I just tell stories like they happen, and then I don't realize people are going to like go attack the company and stuff.
This is what the guy said, actually. This is Joe from South Texas Dragons. You did not purchase that dragon from me. It was purchased from someone else. They contacted me to tell me you were defaming my company all over the internet for something my company was not involved in, and it will stop. You need to contact me immediately. Take down all your disparaging comments and post a public apology. Clearing my company or my next contact will be through my attorney. Sincerely, Joe. And she never did post that apology video, so I wonder if she is having legal repercussions. So here's another thing that I caught. I caught this right here on her video. I don't know if anybody else has caught this, but she says that she reached out to them and had contact with them. And look at her body motions. I know she says in this video like people are gonna pick apart her, the way she's acting and stuff, but just listen to the way she's talking. It's almost like she knows what she's saying is not 100% true. I don't know, but I'm gonna show you something.
People are constantly saying that I never apologized to them when I literally did months and months and months and months ago. I'll pull up the email here. People will probably say it's edited, but we had a conversation.
This struck me as an odd because it doesn't look like a normal email. Because it's obviously in Gmail, which I'm very familiar with, but you can tell that this is a form. And these can be edited. This is from Google Forms. And you say, it says, renew form entry contact. Well, I made my own, and I just want to show you. So, barring a little bit of differences, and the color scheme is different, because you can change the color scheme, it does say, renew fake entry. And it is a similar thing. If you scroll up, you can see it's actually a form, and these are very highly editable, and I sent this to myself, and you can see how easy it is for her to do the same thing. See the difference? If I was just to change my color scheme blue. Now, I can't say definitively that she's lying about reaching out and apologizing. She might have, but for whatever reason, what she chose to display in her video can be falsified on a very easy level. The next thing I want to talk about is in this video, she actually exposes her own self for impulse buying, which pretty much that's the end of the debate if she's an animal hoarder or not. And then she goes on later on in the video, which we'll get to that, actually admitting to animal hoarding. And this is very, very, very,
I didn't even know what kind of monitor I had for a while. It was really bad. It was really, really impulsive of me.
And as you can see, she did admit to not knowing what type of animal she had and that she impulse bought him. That's really dangerous to say that you impulse buy a life. So if you're unfamiliar with what she's talking about, she was hyping up this new pet that she got and she was making it real exciting. And then she posted a video showcasing it, saying that it was one thing, but then in the comments, people knew right away it was another thing. So she didn't even know what she had, and she had this for a month, meaning that she was taking care of it in the wrong way. She did delete her video, and she posted a response and said this. Here's why I deleted today's video. She goes on to say that the owner brought out a black throat, but she said it looks weird, doesn't look like a black throat, pulled out her phone and said, hey, this is what a black throat looks like, and he assured her that it was a black throat. Then when she posted the video and everybody was calling her out saying you've been taking care of this monitor in the wrong way, they said it was a roughneck. She says, once I posted that video, people who have the eye for those monitors confirmed my fears that it was not a black throat and actually a roughneck instead. So I was like, okay, I'll let that pass and I'll just adjust his care to fit roughnecks. But here's where the problem comes in. Roughnecks are wild caught. This goes entirely against my beliefs and I will not profit on a video from an animal that was taken from his home. Well, that's kind of strange because she did that. One Twitter user saying, so we're going to pretend your leaf geckos aren't wild caught. Lol, okay. She said, definitely aren't. Any species that is often wild caught, I go lengths to make sure I only obtain ones that aren't. She says, but you got them from the same place that lied to you about your monitor, so how great of lengths do you actually go to make sure? On Insta, she said she got to see the breeding rooms before the satanics. The satanics are the leaf geckos. She's since deleted those Instagram comments and deleted her original reply to her tweet because someone contacted the store and asked, are your satanic leaf-tailed geckos wild-caught or captive-bred wild-caught? Now, again, I can't say definitively what her motives are behind this, but it does seem she gets caught up in not knowing all her facts. And I know she's been accused of only knowing about as much as the first thing you Google about animals. Those aren't my words. That's what I've been reading. Another thing that was really bothering people was the fact that she was smoking marijuana in her apartment around all her animals. This is something that was... It received a lot of backlash, and even more so when she responded with this.
I don't know, like, oh, you have to be this far or else it's still dangerous. Like, I don't know. I've seen people smoke in the same room as things before, and I didn't understand how dangerous it was, and I've definitely researched now more about it and know never to do it again, but I did do it that one time. And I had my windows open up here. I had these windows open way up there.
I'm not gonna sit here and... pretend to believe that she doesn't know that smoking is harmful. Pretty sure that everybody knows that. This was the worst response to backlash that I've ever seen.
The rat situation, people are saying I impulse bought them. I think there's a difference between unplanned buys and impulsive buys. I was not planning to have rats, but I did think I was fully prepared to take on everything that needed to be taken on.
In the same video, like, this is her alluding to that she does an impulse buy. But in the same video, she said this.
I didn't even know what kind of monitor I had for a while. It was really bad. It was really, really impulsive of me.
Let's look at it objectively. She's a person. We're going to put her aside from her actions. So we separated the person from the actions. We're not talking bad about her, but her actions. They're very stupid. Okay? Those actions. Okay? I'm neutral and unbiased. The actions, those are stupid. Okay? The person's coming back. We're putting them back together. All right. The next thing that she says, well, she admits to animal hoarding. That's what all the drama is about, right? She is an animal hoarder. She says it herself.
There was a period in my life, this is what I'm gonna end this all off on. There was a period in my life where it was about last year until like March or April. So like a good 5 months of me just buying animals, like accumulating animals extremely fast. I went from, you know, having one snake to having like 8 or 9 extremely quick. I brought in Twisty.
All right, look, that's it right there. She's canceled. That's it. I mean, there's really nothing to defend here. Like, the whole controversy was the fact that she was hoarding animals. And by definition, animal hoarding is keeping a higher than usual number of animals as domestic pets without the ability to properly house or care for them, while at the same time denying this inability. Compulsive hoarding can be characterized as a symptom of a mental disorder, and she is admitting to this in this video.
I did some self-reflecting, and there was a time in my life where I was just not happy with myself at all, and the only thing that made me happy was taking care of animals, and I always wanted a new animal to take care of. I still loved everyone that I had, but I wanted to bring in more, and I wanted to keep taking care of animals and just explore.
I mean... I feel like my work's done here. Really. We're right. What do you want me to say? Like, if you ever had the suspicions of her being an animal hoarder, I mean, she said it herself. She has an issue. Those animals are, it's not safe for them to be around her. She needs help. And to make things worse is the news that broke just yesterday. This came out from Johnny Craig's band, the official Slaves account on Twitter, and it says, to whom it may concern, it's with heavy heart that we announce that Johnny Craig has been removed from the band Slaves. We all have struggles in our daily lives, but for some, those struggles are personally and physically dangerous. It is no secret that Johnny has battled with the addiction in his personal life. Sometimes those battles are won, and most recently lost. It's also unfair for a band to rely on someone who just can't rely on themselves. Addiction is a disease, and we hope Johnny gets the help that he needs. Unfortunately, Johnny chose his addiction over the band, left them high and dry while checking in for an international flight while he boarded a plane back home. As a band, we've worked too hard to stop now. Fans that have been touched by our music, everyone that has enjoyed our songs, to everyone that has met us as a band, we will continue with Slaves. Unfortunately, due to this, we are forced to cancel our Bristol, UK show tonight. Never fear, thankfully our good friend Matt McAndrew, who you'd recognize from The Voice, will be filling in on all remaining England and European dates to help in this trying time. We also have some exciting news on the future of Slaves. We think you will be excited coming soon. To everyone, thank you for your continued support. And of course, Taylor had a response to this. Taylor goes on to say, this bandmate called me the R word and blackmailed Johnny for a month, saying if he didn't go on the tour, he would expose the precious little girl I really am. I've got spoken more than a few words with Colin in months. He is guessing. I knew Johnny was going to use if he tried to tour in his mental state, so I encouraged he come home to the program we are doing together at a facility called Clean State. I am in love with Johnny. The last thing I'd ever do is enable him and encourage him to pick up using drugs over his passion of music. We absolutely knew these things were going to be said about us if he didn't do the tour. This is why he was scared to back out. He didn't want to do the tour and he knew it was dangerous for him, but they continued to threaten him and they'd make sure to ruin him and I if he didn't do it. The problem with this is there were screenshots. These screenshots expose Taylor for what she is really doing. Colin on Twitter says, I didn't even want to expose her like that, but if she has the audacity to try and lie her way out of this by blaming people who have done everything for Johnny, she will get exposed in like 2 seconds. One Twitter user says, I keep hearing Taylor contributed to this S and I must say, I'm not happy with it. He says, yeah, man, he has been using heroin with him. Meanwhile, the band's been fighting for his life for years. These are the leaked DMs from Taylor and Colin. Taylor is in green. You tell my mom who can't legally do anything and all that'll do is hurt her, not me. I think your parents need to know exactly who their little girl is. I'm trying to sober up so hard, closer than ever been. He got you hooked on some heavy S, that's true love. I wouldn't wish that upon my worst enemy. And you're sitting at home doing the drugs that are killing Johnny and ruined his whole career. You really do not know anything. No, Taylor, you don't know anything. When he's dead, you will be the enabler. You know nothing about what's going on. If you think that will work, then you don't understand addiction. Are you effing kidding me? It's the same effing thing, you idiot. And yeah, F me for giving an S, that's the truth. And you said he needs supportive people around him. LOL, you're doing the drugs that are killing him with him. You will be exposed, promise you that. And exposed she just has been. And these next DMs here are from Johnny. Johnny is in the gray. For how long? 11, probably earlier. Want to make a run for me? What am I going to get? Drugs, I want to get back on my good side. Help me. Cause you know Taylor's gonna be able to tell. She's doing them with me. Tomorrow we are going back to full on sober. And if you tell anyone, I will kill you. So if you haven't been keeping up with it, I know it was a lot. It's been a topic of controversy for a couple years now that she has not been in the correct mental state to take care of her animals. And because of this, there have been literally 52 deaths and maybe more. The conditions that her animals are in are unsafe electrically, so many other ways, and now it's been exposed that she is doing heroin, probably other drugs, and the animals themselves need to be taken away out of that environment. I truly believe that those animals will live a better and more secure life if they're away from Taylor Nicole Dean. I'm really wanting to know what you guys think about this. On the other hand, about the addiction, my mother suffered addiction for probably like 20 years. And I know how difficult that is. And I truly, sincerely hope. And yes, she did the same. She did heroin. I truly hope that they get better. I want them to get off that. They need to worry about themselves first. I really believe that. And the animals need to be taken away. They need to work on themselves. Taylor needs to get her head back on her shoulders. But as interesting as this video is, there's always something that's more interesting to me. That's right, you guessed it. I want to know what you think. So why don't you go ahead and leave your creative and interesting responses in the comment box below.
Thumbs up for this like.
As always, brothers and sisters, I will see you in the next video. This video was really difficult to stay neutral and unbiased for the simple purpose of, like, animals, they mean a lot to me. And it's clear to me that she had an issue from the get-go. And the things, like, I didn't put everything into this video. I will put a lot of links in the description. You're going to want to check those out. But there's a clear problem here, and it needs addressed. And it sucks that people are going through difficult things like this. And I mean, they're not the only ones. They're just internet celebrity personalities that are, you know, it's public. Me and you and everyone has been going through these things for years, and we know the pain that it brings with it. So hopefully everything gets worked out. Because I know that you're repping, if you're repping, you're Greg. And how you do that, all you gotta do is subscribe, notifications turned on, be in the comment section to every single video, because I'm gonna be there, Greg the Cat's gonna be there, and the rest of the Rep Squad community as well. And I expect to see you there too, because this channel loves you.
I know I say this a lot, but I am starving.